So much stuff is happening like these days, Ellen. I think like there's just a lot that's happening in our spaces and just like in the world in general. But in the meantime,
Yeah.
there's also a lot to cover.
Cool. Like, I mean, you might have noticed that the background is a bit different. So, yeah, this is why.
So the big news is that Ellen and his family has just bought a new, can you say that? A new house. A new house, a brand new house.
Brand new.
I feel like I'm exaggerating.
Brand new secondhand.
So Ellen has bought a house and this is like a really great achievement for him, and we're really happy for you, Ellen. And I think from today's episode, we're really gonna be uncovering the amount of work that goes behind like buying a house, because again, just that sounds like much more simpler. I mean, you might agree, Ellen. It sounds so much simpler to say like, buy a house, just buy a house. You go to the store, can I have that house? There's the money, then done. But there's seems like there's a lot that goes in towards that process. And in this episode, we're just gonna be chatting to Ellen about that, and just like any tips that you put out there, because normally people in our age are not having buying a house conversations, man. This is not just like
And that, I think that made it more difficult, man, because look, we were first trying to do everything very secretive, man, because it's like you don't tell everyone yet, because now you're hoping, look, just the way we grew up, it's like you don't celebrate till it's in your hand, man. It's not like, oh, I'm excited because I might have this thing, I must have it now, then you can be excited. So that was always like the approach that we took. But oh, it was super difficult. And what's funny is, no, so we've been renting for like, look, I'm 24 now. So we've been renting for 24 years. So it was like a very long time. And it's like, look, we wanted to buy, but it's always like, sometimes we don't qualify at the bank. And then the other time it's like, now we don't want to qualify, but then we move to a place we don't want to be at, man. So it was always like, how do we find a house that we are able to afford, but then at the same time, you know, it's in the area that we want with the resources that we want. And that was like the biggest challenge. That's why it took like 24 years. I mean,
And I guess that's what makes it like even extra special, the fact that you had to wait for like 24 years. 24 years is like a long time.
I waited my whole life, you could say.
So I mean, now I think, Alan, just like briefly, where do you start, man? Like, when you want to buy a house, What's the first step? I don't know if there's like an actual first step, but
I mean, I don't even see the stairs. Like,
you are sitting on the floor,
on the floor, I'm just
with no like stairs, no steps to take whatsoever.
Yo, show me to the staircase. Yo, but what's funny is because we always wanted to buy a house, man.
Yeah.
But we never like planned to buy a house now, because now lockdown is happening.
Yeah,
we're all at home. We're not thinking. But then we just. What's funny is a senior member from the church that I attend called me and was like, I need you to come over to my house and then help me with this online banking stuff. So that's the only reason I went. And then on my way home, I was walking and I saw, okay, there's a house for sale. This is like in the area. Let me just see like what's happening with this house. And I went online and I got the person's details, messaged the real estate agent. And we're like, yo, this is perfect because, you know, it's right where I live. It's like, you know, 2 minutes away from my current house.
Yeah.
And that works. But then my mom was like, she doesn't like the cupboards or whatever. And we're like, yo, but, and my was like, no, but now there's no walls in front. So our current house has no walls either. So we're like, okay, and our current cupboards are also like broken.
Yeah.
Like, okay, that house also has broken cupboards and a broken wall. Like, I guess it's fine for me. But my mom was like, nah, she doesn't want to move there. There's no, you know, nice cupboards.
Yeah.
It was very important to her.
Yeah.
My dad wanted to live there because it's close to our house. Same bus route, same everything.
Mm.
But then it was like, okay, we're not. But then I messaged the real estate agent. And I mean, the guy asked me for my details and whatever, and got my family's information and our earnings and all that kind of stuff. And the guy's like, no, you guys do qualify. And I'll be in touch. And then, you know, he wasn't in touch. So then I contacted the guy, like, I mean, like 2 weeks later, yo, what's happening? And he's like, oh yeah, we sold the house. We were like, yo, man. Because we got excited, man. We made a mistake. We're like, yo, bro, we got excited.
Yeah.
But then I was like, yo, what are we gonna do, man? Because we now we're excited about moving, the possibilities there.
Yeah.
And we're like, okay, online, you know, I'm searching property 24, seeing houses in Portland. And we like found the area in Portland and it's like, you know, nice cupboards. for my mom bought them covers. I was like, yeah, she likes the covers.
It's part of like the search history, house like in Portland with nice covers.
Nice covers. And then my mom was like, ah, oh, she likes this house. And my dad's like, nah, but it's at a terrible location. So far from everywhere. You're like taking the bus. Now you're going to walk for like, you know, 10 minutes either direction to get to it. And where we live like 10 minutes from the town center. So that's like in Mitchell's Plain. If you're trying to go anywhere, you know, in Cape Town, you can jump into a taxi from basically from town center. So now we would give up that and for long walks, you know, and we don't want that to happen, man. So basically then we contacted also the person and we're like, okay, you guys qualify and like here's the details, here's our credit score, I'll be in touch. And then like I keep messaging him and he wasn't in touch. And it's like, Now I started to think, okay, maybe it's us, man. That's weird now. This man is not in touch. And then he's like, just no one coming back to us. And then I remember we kept searching because now it's like, yo, everyone's already like invested now, man. But look, how much time do we want to hear no? And I kept saying, look, I can hear no up until I hear yes, man. Even if it's like 1,000 times, I don't care how much times I must hear no, but it doesn't. Like, why must we stop? Yeah, no, up until you hear yes. So that, and then it was like, cause someone sent my mom a picture of this house for sale in the road that we live. And my mom's like, yo, Ellen, there's this house for sale. But I don't know where it is. Do you know where this house is? And it's like, oh, it's the house next door.
And just in case people don't believe it, you're gonna see the distance that it took from Ellen.
We're like,
from one house to the other one.
We don't even know how much the house cost. In our minds now, we can't afford to move into this house, man. So now we're like, now we're gonna keep pursuing like this Portland's house and whatever. And then because that guy didn't get back to us, we dealt with like this nice lady. I'm just gonna, you know, shout out to Kayla Biggs, Pam Golding. She was like solid, man. She's like for real.
Yeah.
Like, okay, what are your details? You already did the assessment by the other guys. It's fine. Just send that to me. We don't have to reassess anything because if you qualify there, it's the same thing. And she's like going out of her way and contacting us and letting us know and walking down through the process. And I mean, it was, you know, solid, man. So I was like, yeah, no. You know, I don't want to go like, you know, gender vibes, but it's like, yo, the man didn't like, no, he disappointed me, and this lady's like solid.
Solid. I think for just like a shout out to her again, like, I think all the ladies that are like experiencing tough times, like in the real estate, like, market, like people undermining you just because you're a female, I think this goes on to say, like,
top. Yo, I mean, 10 out of 10.
and I think we were chatting about, like, just like, the paperwork involved like in the actual process.
Yo, bro, like, you know, it's funny, I was trying to keep it like very secretive, but so since when I work together and it's like, yo, now I'm not like available, I'm busy the whole time. Now it's like, yo, I must at least let this man know what's going on.
Yeah.
She can like, oh, Alan, he's not responding, he's not doing this stuff, the stuff is not done, what's happening? And I'm sitting there like, yo, I can't think about like work, man. I'm here about what he must do, but
I think it goes back to that thing that you mentioned about being invested in the actual process, because I can imagine the excitement and like now you want to read this thing, then obviously the other stuff is going to get compromised along the way.
Because I always hear about people when they're signing contracts, oh no, we didn't actually read this clause, you know, in the fine print, all that stuff.
Yeah.
So for me, it's like, look, I only want to read the fine print.
Show me section 128, clause B, like, I want to read that.
Exactly, bro, that's how it was. And I'm like reading through the stuff and now we're having to explain. And I mean, we'd never bought a house before. It's not like a common thing.
Yeah.
I mean, people are not regularly buying houses because once you buy house, you live in it, you're not like buying it again. I was joking with Senzo, like everyone we know that bought the house bought it, you know, like 30 years ago, man, when it was like 5,000 rand to buy the house. And then it was, then I didn't have to think about transfer fees, any of that stuff. And I'll get into that a bit later. But yeah, so now it's like, you know, reading this contracts. But again, look, Kayla was solid, man. She's like, look, what don't you guys understand? I'll come through. Even like in lockdown, we adhere to social distancing, compliance, all that stuff.
Sanitized. She was wearing a mask. Maybe one of the masks that we talked about in the previous episode.
So she was like, solid reading through the contract. Well, okay, this is what this means. This is how you must apply. Explaining to my parents what community of property means and how they must both sign.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it was like new for everyone. So the half the time, you're like, yo, this is like, you know, so much. But I mean, she just made it like super clear. And then we started to learn, like, you know, there's different like cost associated that you don't think about, because now okay, so the house we bought was like 850,000 rand, so now it's like okay, you can get the bond and loan, all these kind of things, but now it's like you see estimations on the site, so the site goes okay, 850,000 rand a month, your estimation will be you're going to pay 6,000 rand a month. We're like, well, it's even cheap, we can like, because we're like three people working in the house, it's doable, we were paying more or less the same in terms of like rent we were currently staying, but then you start to like really, you know, now you must apply for home loans and stuff, and it's like,
and maybe that's another interesting thing, some of the things that people don't know about, like before they buy a house, and then like can you maybe run through like some of the things that people now you come across that, but it's not something that was not considered on the, as you say, on the website with the estimation.
I don't know who they're using for the estimation. That's like I don't know, that's the best interest rate I ever saw. Like I don't know, that man is on like -5% interest or something. We didn't get that interest rate, so that's the stuff we don't learn. Like I had to learn things like prime real estate interest was like 7%, but we got it for like 9%, but because my dad works for the government, we got like a 1% discount, and we're like, oh, 1%. But now you start to work out like how much you will pay per month, and it's like, okay, so it can be, you know, 7,000 rand a month, but if 1% discount means it's like 600 to 800 rand less. It's like, yeah, we need, you know, we need that.
Yeah, bring
what about that 1%? It's 1% club. Yeah. So now it's like, okay, we need to do that. But then they start talking about other stuff, like you need to ensure, you know, the bricks and mortar of the house. Like in case the fire burns like the brick, the house down to when it's just the foundation, they must rebuild the house from scratch. So you must ensure that, you know, that kind of thing. Then you must also ensure like, you know, your lives, because, you know, again, very sad and emotional. Most people will die, and we're going to be sad about that. But then we must now pay the house, man. So then what happens? So now it's like, okay, but we can't insure my dad because he's like over the age, and my mom is just close. So it's like, oh, if I insure just myself, then it's like 300 rand a month. But if I have to insure my mom and myself, now it's like 1,100 rand a month. So it's like, do I love my mother? No? That's the, you start to tell yourself, I'm here for my family. No, but 1,000 rand is not like, I don't just have 1,000 rand. But it's also like, well, if my mom dies, and it's again, very sad, emotional, all that stuff, then the house is paid off, man. So it's like, you know, that makes sense. That's a worthwhile investment. And in our communities, people are not taking out life insurance policies because we feel bad. But I was telling him, so look, I don't feel bad about this stuff, but it makes sense. Let's think about the rest of the family.
Yeah.
I don't want my mom to die, none of that stuff. But I mean, we have to think about it. So we basically had to do that. So now it's like, instead of 7,000, now it's like, you know, 8,000 something.
Yeah,
and it's not close to like the 6,000 that they and then you're like, okay, now it's cool, we're just gonna now get like a loan for 800,000, and now we apply to like different banks and stuff, man. So now we worked with this one company, apparently it's a company that they use, that Pam Golding used, that you apply through, and then they apply to all the banks on your behalf, so you don't like run with your stuff.
But that's like a really nice process.
And they send us like these documents that you must like fill in, and then we didn't have, I sent it to them. But it was a PDF that I could edit. But every time I save the PDF, then you can't edit it anymore. It was some weird setup like that. I could only edit the original one that they sent.
Yeah.
So then literally for that week or two while we sent the documents back, I didn't like shut down my computer, didn't exit the PDF in case I need to edit it. Because I'm like, I can't go back and edit like three documents from my mom and my dad talking about where do they live. It was really awkward, you know, asking like your parents, okay, how much do you earn?
That's like a conversation that is never had in our communities. Like no one like really knows what their parents like really earns.
You know, they're having that conversation.
Like now you must have it over and over every time when like a different bank, like you must submit like your documentation.
So now it's like, okay, we all agree, look, we need to explain, so we all know where we're standing. So we did it, once is enough, you know, once is almost too much, I would say, but we need to get it out. And then what's cool is, so then the Uber people, they sorted out all that stuff, and then, I mean, we start to get feedback from the banks and stuff. Now I get feedback, I forget the bank's name, that the order they gave us feedback, a person's like, okay, you want a loan of 850,000? We can offer you 800,000. And we're like, nah, but I mean, that was not gonna make sense. then, okay, now we get the back from the other person, then it's the same thing. We can offer you like, you know, 780,000. We can offer you this and all these amounts are like really below.
Yeah.
But like, mind you, that the first guy that we went with, you were saying, no, you guys can qualify for a loan of 1.2 million. So we're like, you know, 800,000. That's fine. We're not going to worry. We don't want like a mall. We just want, you know, 8.5, whatever. And then, nah, it's not like that, man.
And like 50,000 is a lot of money to just have like lying around, man. It's not like an amount that everyone would just like have like in general.
Yeah, like, yo, I just need like 50K in case I need to, you know, buy a house one day in the future.
Yeah.
So exactly, we're not like living like that, man. And I guess that's also part of the problem, because eventually, like SA Home Loans, you know, they came through like, nah, full loan amount.
Yeah,
that works.
Shout out to
SA Home Loans. Solid. Oh, no one is sponsoring us to say this. This is just purely our experience.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, they said, your dad works for the government, whatever, here you go. A discount on that, and we'll sort you out, and someone on the phone. And they just, the process with them was also just like solid. And I remember the guy, Rudolph, nah, his work ethic is different. Like, a man phoned you like 7 o'clock in the morning, man, starting early. Did you get the email I sent? Okay, I sent the email to you, you know, at Oppo 60. I just want to make sure you got it. Stuff like that, man, on a different level in terms of like helping you and support. So, I mean, Mr. Rudolph, like, you solid as well.
Mm.
So that was like really nice. So, everything was working, you know, up until this point. And then, yeah, now it's just, we just have to like wait. Oh, the one thing I forgot to mention was there's a lot of other fees. So it's like, okay, the house is 850,000, but now the SA Home Loans can give you a loan in principle, but now they must send someone to the house you're going to buy to go and evaluate to see if the house is really worth 850.
Yeah.
And the guy comes, signs off. Then they have to send the electrician to make sure that all the plugs are working. And then they must get a certificate for that. They must have the plumber, is all the taps working? Then they must get a certificate. And then, so that like takes long to get done.
Mm.
Because I mean, look, it makes sense that all the lights must work, but you didn't think it's like an official thing.
Yeah, someone that must check, you check by switching it on and off, and that's the check.
And we just trust everyone, many all the lights work. Oh wait, nah, the lights work, that's why. But they must get the official certificate, man. And because it's like business, and they were even telling us, so if we're living in the house and there's something like a leak, no, we can take it back because there was a certificate issued that there's no problems. Now you got like this peace of mind, man.
Mm.
And I think that is like tops. And then there's also things that you just didn't think about, like transfer fees and like lawyers cost. So now it's like, okay, to transfer the deed from the existing owner to us, now it's like, what is that process even, man? Like, we don't know. We get information from the lawyers and they're like, okay, we drew up these contracts and we're doing this and we're doing whatever. I mean, they were also, you know, very nice. We just didn't understand like a lot of the stuff. I mean, so I'll just shout out, you know, Sally and Sally. They were also the lawyers that handled it.
Yeah.
They were like also solid, but it was just confusing to us because we didn't know that there would be like transfers fees and lawyer costs.
Mm.
And it's not like, you know, it's not pocket change cost, man. It's like, okay, how much is the transfer fees? Okay, transfer fees, 20,000. That's like, oh, bro, where are we transferring to? I'm then moving next door. Just go there on the document, you know, update number 6 to number 8. Okay, we just, how much does that cost? And, transfer fees, like hectic. And then on the other end, it's like, now that's just for transfer. Now that's not lawyer's fees. That's just for the deeds office.
Oh.
Now the lawyers must also pay their fees. And that's like, you know, that's another 20K for just lawyer's fees. So now it's like, you're not even buying a house, man, but you must have like 50K just to think about buying. And it's like, yo, maybe we should just rent, man. You know what I mean? In 5,000,
much more easier.
We don't have to worry. Don't have to insure my bricks. Now I must insure my bricks and pay these lawyers and stuff. But we did find out that you can then take out a loan to pay for like transfer fees in addition to the loan that you're doing.
Nice.
So and also find like once they like allocate this home loan to you, they allocate like an extra amount that you can access at a later date in case you want to do like renovations.
Wow.
So we took out the loan for 850,000, but then they made an additional like 50,000 available that you can access like later on. Oh, I mean, we must pay for it, man. You see, it's like,
it sounds like a blessing, man. Yeah. The dividend owners come through and they're like, hey.
No, I see. If the cost is so much to move next door, you know, I'm not taking the 50K. No, thank you, man. In fact, you keep it. So that was more like our approach, man. We just wanted to share this because we don't. It's just the thing that I didn't know, and I mean, we assume that there's a lot of people that don't know this. But I would say it's a good investment.
Yeah.
All the research that I've done is like showing, okay, if you have a house, you can think of it like a savings plan.
Yeah.
If you're lazy to save, you're just saving into your bond and eventually your own equity in the house. So it's like a type of savings plan.
Nah,
so that, I mean, that's dope.
That's like a solid episode. And thank you so much, Alan, for sharing your story. Let us know, like, what do you think? Did you know some of the things that you mentioned, like, in this video, like, are you thinking of buying a house? Do you need Alan's number so that you can call him, like, if you need some advice? But yeah, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next episode.
Yo guys, so I moved, so I used to live here. So in case you're looking for me, I'll just show you like where my new house is. Yeah, so I moved here. So if you guys are looking for me, this is where I am. Bye.